We are taking R.D. Sharma Solutions, Class 10 Maths, Chapter 16, Exercise 16.1. And this exercise is for surface area and volume. First question is, how many balls each of radiuses 1 cm can be made from solid sphere of lead of radius 8 cm? So, a solid sphere is there. And there are number of balls being made. So, the volume of the bigger ball, let me say B, bigger ball, will be equal to volume of the smaller balls. And how many are there? We don't know. N. So, this is the relationship which we have to use. So, what is the volume of a sphere? It is 4 by 3 pi r cube. 4 by 3 pi, let me say the capital R for this one. R cube is equal to 4 by 3 pi r cube for the smaller one. And we don't know how much they are. So, how many they are. So, just put some n here. Just cancel this 4 by 3 pi, 4 by 3 pi here. R cube, this the bigger one is 8 cube. Right? And the smaller one is 1. So, it doesn't matter. 1 into 1 into 1, 1 only. So, n will be equal to 8 into 64, 64 into 3 is 512. So, there are 512 balls. These number of balls are made up from this solid sphere. How many spherical bullets each of 5 cm in diameter? So, the bullets are in spherical shape. 5 cm in diameter. So, 5 cm is the diameter. Can be cast from a rectangular block of metal, and the metal is having the length, breadth and height like this. Now, one thing we have to see here is the dimensions. First of all, before going to solving this question, the dimensions are different. That means it is centimeter, this is decimeter, this is meter and this is decimeter. So, we have to convert all of these into one, means same dimensions, right? So, what we will do, we will first this 11 decimeter, let us convert into meter. So, just divide it by 2, 1 meter will be 1 meter, decimeter, it is you have to divide it by 10, okay. So, what do you get? This volume of, actually volume of this block, let me say VB, has to be equal to the number of spherical bullets. So, volume of one spherical bullet and n is the number of bullets. So, what is the volume of block? Volume of block is 11 by 10 into this 1 by 1 and 5 by 10 is equal to n into Vs, and this is the volume of this spherical one. So, this diameter is 5, so the radius will become what? 5 by 2, that is 2.5 centimeter. And we have to convert this 2.5 centimeter into the meter, because if it is in meter, that then no problem. But if it is in centimeter, we have to convert it also. Okay. So let me just change it into 4 by 3 pi 3.14 into pi r cube. This 5, 2.5. So 2.5, and we have to divide it by 100. 0.025. So, when we solve this, n is going to come as 8400. The solution is in front of you. I am not going to actually solve this. The basic thing is to have the idea how to solve. What is the logic behind this question? Otherwise, these are in front of you only. A spherical ball of radius 3 cm is melted and recast into 3 spherical balls. So, there is a spherical ball and now we have recasted it into 3 spherical balls. The radii of 2 balls, these are 2 and 1.5 centimeter. So, one is 2 centimeter, one is 1.5 centimeter. What is the diameter of the third ball? So, we have to find out the diameter. Let us say the radius is r. We'll find out the diameter as 2r later. This is a spherical ball of radius 3 centimeter, the basic balls. This is 3 centimeter. So, what we have to do, volume of the bigger ball will be equal to volume of say 1, 2, 3. These are the numbers. It will be V1 plus V2 plus V3. This is what we have to do. So VB is volume of the bigger ball, that is 4 by 3 pi. Then R cube, this is 3 already given, so 3 cube. This is 3 cube. This will be equal to 4 by 3 pi. And then we have this 2. 2 is the radius. So 2 cube plus 4 by 3 pi. Now 1.5 cube plus 4 by 3 pi. And this R we don't know, R cube. Just cancel it out. This is 3 cube equal to 2 cube plus 1.5 cube plus R cube. So you have to solve for R cube. And this R will come as 2.5. This is the solution, right? This is the solution in front of you. This is just mathematics, or you can use the calculator also. So the radius is 2.5, but we have to find out the diameter. So just imagine that when you read this question, you'll be tempted to solve it for R. But the question is asking for diameter. So we have to say D equal to 2R. And this is 2 into 2.5, that is 5.0 centimeter. 2.2 cubic decimeter of brass is to be drawn into cylindrical wire of this much, 0.25 centimeter diameter. Find the length of the wire. So here we have this one, 2.2 cubic decimeter. That is 2.2 decimeter cube. So this 2.2 decimeter cube is what? It is the volume. Whenever it is in the cubic form, it is volume. This of brass is drawn into a cylindrical wire. So we have a cylindrical wire. Say this is the cylindrical wire. And the diameter is given as, this is the diameter, 0.25 centimeter diameter. So radius will be what? It will be by 2. This is the radius. So the volumes are same. And we know the radius of this cylindrical one. But we don't know the height, or you can say length. So just say it as a height. We will just equate the volume because it is already given volume. So this is decimeter cube. We will convert it into meter. Let us convert everything into meter. So 2.2 and decimeter cube. So 1 decimeter is 1 by 10 meter. So it will be 10 by 10 cube. So the volume will be 2.2 into 10 to the power minus 3. This one. And this will be equal to, now volume of the cylinder is pi r square h. So pi, say 22 by 7 R square. This is 0.25 by 2, so it will become 0.125. And we have this in centimeters, so I have to convert it into meter and then square it and then height. So height we have to find. This is the solution in front of you. So height will come as 448 meter. This is the answer. What length of solid cylinder 2 centimeter in diameter be taken to recast into a hollow cylinder of length 16 cm, external diameter 20 cm and thickness 2.5 mm. So here we have, first of all, a solid cylinder, that means this one. So we have a solid cylinder and this has to be recasted into a hollow cylinder like this. Now we have a hollow cylinder here. So what length of solid cylinder? 2 centimeter. So what is the length? We don't know. Let us say it as h. 2 centimeter is the diameter. 2 centimeter is diameter. 2 centimeter is diameter. So radius will be 1 centimeter. To be taken to recast into hollow cylindrical or cylinder of length. So height here given as 16 centimeter. Diameter of external diameter is 20. So external diameter is 20. So the radius external will be 20 by 2, that is 10. So now radius external is 10. And what is the width? Width is given as 2.5. But it is in millimeter. It is in millimeter. So what we have to do here is this 10. From here to here it is 10. So in order to find out the internal radius, that is RI, internal radius, we have to subtract from 10 this width, and which is 2.5 millimeter. So I have to convert it into centimeter. So 2.5 millimeter, I have to divide it by 10. So it will be minus 0.25. Okay. R will be 10 minus 0.25, which will be RI, will be 19.75. So we have internal diameter as 9.75, external as 10. So the volume of this one, volume of say hollow cylinder, will be equal to volume of the actual cylinder. So I just say this as solid cylinder. So volume of solid cylinder has to be equal to volume of hollow cylinder. What is the volume of the solid one? Which is pi r square h. So just say pi r square, because the radius is 1 centimeter, so I am just writing 1 square. And h, what is the height? We don't know. This we have to find out. And let us equate it to this one. So the volume of the hollow cylinder will be volume of the external one minus volume of the internal one. That is pi r, and this external h minus pi r internal one, internal h. So just pi cancel it out, 1 square, so h will be this. I am taking now this h, so this h is already given, which is 16. And this will be r e square minus r I square, that is 10 square minus 9.75 square. So the solution is here, height will come as 79.04 centimeter. A cylindrical vessel having the diameter equal to its height is full of water, which is poured into two identical cylindrical vessels with diameter 42 cm and height 21 cm, which are filled completely. Find the diameter of the cylindrical vessel. So what is happening here is, we have a cylindrical vessel. Now this is having some water, full of water actually. And this has to be poured into two identical cylinders. For this one, only the thing is given is the diameter is equal to the height. So diameter equal to height, that is diameter is 2r, radius is height here. And then the question being asked is find the diameter of the cylindrical vessel. So we have to find out the diameter. So we'll go with the r, we'll replace h. Just see what I'm doing here. For this one, the diameter is 42 centimeter. So the radius will be what? 42 by 2, that is 21 centimeter. Radius for this one. And height is given as 21. So volume of this one will be volume of this one. So we'll just equate the volume. What is the volume here? It is pi r. The volume of cylinder is pi r square h. Pi r square h. Now r square, as I said, we have to replace this h. So h is what? 2r. So I'll write pi r as r square and h as 2r. And this is equal to what? This volume. Volume of this is pi r square h. R is 21 and height is also 21. 21 square into 21 is pi r square h. So pi cancels. This is what? 2r cube. R square and r will become 2r cube. This will be 21 square into 21 by 2. Take the cube root. R will come as 21 centimeter. R will come as 21, because actually this 2 pi r square h, 2r and r square already became r cube. And we have this pi r square into h, 21 into 21. And since we have this 2 along with this, we just equated them. And when we equated them, the r came as 21 centimeter, and this diameter is going to be 42 centimeter, which is equal to, this diameter is what? 2 into r. So 2 into r is 21 into 2 is 42. Okay. Now one thing is here, diameter is equal to twice is equal to height. Diameter is equal to height. So this diameter is equal to height, that is 2r equal to h we have taken. And these are 2. These are 2. So you will be surprised that this 21 square and 21 by 2, how it came as 21 cube. Because these are 2, so we have to multiply it by 2. This is the only thing. I have to multiply because these are 2. 1 plus 1. So I have to multiply it by 2. 2 goes. This r cube will become 21 square into 21, that is at 21 cube. So r will become directly 21. I hope you got the idea. We have to multiply it by 2 because these are 2 identical cylinder. And this 2 was already there. This 2. So I cancel this 2 with this 2. 50 circular plates, each of diameter 14 cm and thickness 0.5 cm, are placed one above the other. to form a right circular cylinder. Find the total surface area. So one of these is this one. Okay, so there is a stack. There is a stack of this one, one placed over another. So I'll just take one of these and just let you imagine this I am placing one over the another. So it will grow up. So what this, there are 50 circular plates, each of diameter 14 centimeter. So the diameter is given as 14 centimeter. Radius will become 7 centimeter, 14 by 2. The thickness is 0.5 centimeter. One thickness of one is 0.5 centimeter. Now how many are these? 50. So I multiply it by 50. When I multiply it by 50, then I get the height. That is like this. So now this becomes the height. So this thickness is nothing but the height, which is coming as 50 into 0.5 is 25 centimeter. Now we have the height, we have the radius. We have to find out the total surface area. Total surface area is 2 pi r h plus r. This is the total surface area. Actually, it is this one, pi r square plus pi r square, the above one and below one, which is 2 pi r square, and the this curved surface area is 2 pi r h. So curved surface area with the above, that is the top and bottom area, is actually the total surface area. Now we have this 2 into 22 by 7 into this radius is 7, h is 25, which we got here, and then 7 is the radius, of course. So this is going to be 1408 centimeter square. Please remember that the total surface area and the curved surface area will always come in centimeter square or square units. But when we talk about volume, it is going to come as the cubic unit. So it will be power of 3, any unit to the power of 3. 25 circular plates, each of radius 10.5 centimeter and thickness 1.6 centimeter. Place one above the other to form a solid circular cylinder. Find the curved surface area and the volume of the cylinder so far. So this question is exactly similar to the previous one. The only thing is here the curved surface area is being asked. So curved surface area is 2 pi rh and volume is pi r square h. This we have to find. So we have 25 circular plates, radius is, so I'm just taking the one. So you can imagine the, we are placing one over the another. So if the radius is 10.5, so radius is 10.5 and height will be what? Because there are 25 circular plates and one thickness is 1.6. So 25 into 1.6 will be the height, 25 into 1.6, which is going to come as 40 centimeter. So the curved surface area will be 2 into 22 by 7 into 10.5 into the height, which is 40, and the volume will be 22 by 7 into r square, which is this one, 10.5 whole square into height. Height is 40. So this will be 2 pi rh, and 2 pi rh will come as 2640, and the volume will come as 13860. So this is the answer. Now the diameter of a metallic sphere is equal to 9 centimeter. It is melted and drawn into long wires of diameter this much, 2 millimeter, having uniform cross section. Find the length of the wire. So the diameter of the metallic sphere. So here is a sphere and a metallic wires are being formed. The diameter is given as 9 centimeter. So diameter is 9 centimeter. The radius will be diameter by 2. So radius is 4.5 centimeter. So the volume of the sphere will be equal to volume of the cylinder. Volume of the first one, which is sphere, will be 4 by 3 pi r cube. So 4 by 3 pi into r cube. R cube, because it is 9 by 2, that is 4.5, so 4.5 whole cube. And this is equal to the volume of this uniform cross section. And the volume of this cylinder will be pi. I'm just writing pi. Pi will get cancelled. Pi r square. Now, r radius is given as 2 millimeter. So diameter will be 1 millimeter. But because it is in millimeter, I have to convert it into centimeter. So I'll divide it by 10. So it will be 0.1. 0.1 whole square into height. Height has to be known. It is to be computed. So now we have this 4 by 3. Then this gets cancelled. 4.5 whole cube. And this divided by 0.1 whole square. H will be your 12150 centimeter. This is the calculation actually. This is what I told you. The calculation of this part will be this one. And this part 0.1 whole squared, this will be this one. Find the number of smaller sphere required if the radius of larger ball is 4 times the radius of the smaller ball. Find the number of balls required. So we have a bigger one and we have a smaller one. So volume of the bigger one will be equal to volume of the smaller one, and we don't know how many numbers are there, so I just multiply it by n. Find the number of smaller sphere required here. If the radius of the larger ball, this radius is, if the radius of the smaller ball is r, radius of the bigger ball will be 4r. Okay, it is 4 times the radius of the smaller ball. So what we'll do, the volume of the ball is 4 by 3 pi into 4r cube. This will be equal to n, n we have to find out, and this is 4 by 3. So this is 4 by 3 and pi into r cube. R cube is what? This one, r cube. Now the thing is 4 by 3, 4 by 3, pi, 4 by 3, 4 by 3 get cancelled. And this is 4 into 4 into 4, 4 into 4 into 4. So what do we get? 4 into 4 into 4 r cube is equal to n into r cube. So r cube get cancelled. What do we get? We get this, the number of this, the radius. So 4 fours are 16. 16 fours are 64. So this answer is 64 actually. So this answer is 64. This is what is the answer. The other things are also being shown. If it is being asked, you can just take the ratio of any of the thing, like the curved surface area, like the volume, or the total surface area. You just have to write the formula and just place one as 4r, other as r. So this is the first part of this exercise. We'll be taking more of this later. Thank you so much. Take care of yourself.